here we go into the system, and there's the Frank Flipper deal. So if I click on that, I will see a brand new submission. It looks like it was a broker involved, and there it is. This broker's approved with us, and I can click on soft credit pool, and I'll get a credit score on this borrower. And this is everything that was filled out on the quick app. So as a broker, I would maybe check out the marketplace. And I would say, all right, let's see who can do this type of fix and flip deal with this LTV, ARV in this state. And then we have a list of, you know, suggested lenders, right? And so you can add your own lenders to the mix here. If you have your own capital providers, hard money lenders, private money lenders, you can add them to this list. They'd be unique to your environment only. And our system lets you kind of build out a profile with the max LTV, LTC, ARV, what their niches are, you know, their details, requirements for processing, underwriting, upload any commonly used documents. And more importantly, you can click on the submit financing request and it goes to your main contact there and sends out this email that's pre-formatted with a link to the deal room. If you don't like our built-in template, you can change it to your own email template that it's structured the way you want with all the dynamic fields. But that deal room, just to show you what it looks like, this is what the lender would get. A preview of the deal in read-only mode, of course, and they can submit an offer here and let you know what the rate is, the points, the LTV, and they can upload their term sheet. So that's a great way to compare offers, right, that have been submitted. So assuming, you know, you sent it out to a few lenders, you would go here and say, all right, Archwest gave me a quote, 10.5 and 1.5 points, 80% LTV. You know, ABC lender, you know, gave me this deal offer, right? So you can compare all the different offers and store them and, you know, select the ones that you want to quote with the borrower. In the future, we'll have a quote matrix that you can select to the client. Can see which are the preferred, you know, quotes that you recommend, and they can choose whichever one they want. But when you're ready to go into submitting the term sheet, you know, all you got to do is just set the rate, right? So I'm going to do 11.5, and that's it. It auto calculates the payment. I can set this to be a Dutch versus non-Dutch, right? So now it's 38.33. And by the way, all the fields that you see in here, you can turn some of these off. You know, if you don't need doc type, for example, or type of purchase, where it came from, you know, occupancy, lien position, right? Some of these things are just extra fluff that you don't need. You can turn that off in the back end and or make it dynamic to certain loan products. So maybe a non-QM DSCR loan, you'll want doc type in there. And you can make that field dynamic. So system can be really, really smart. All right, so at this point, we got our points. You know, notice how this is auto-populated. You can save your preferences to like what your points and fees are per product in your system. So that's super handy and helpful to keep things moving fast, efficiently. You can obviously override that or add additional fees. So I might add a, you know, $850 underwriting fee on this file. And you can set the prepayment penalty if you want. You can also indicate if there is a interest reserve or payment reserve that needs to be verified in bank statements and stuff, cash to close. Regarding payment reserve, you can actually do what a lot of lenders do is your prepaid interest reserve. So you can set that to yes and factor that in and put, you know, 24,000, you know, 6 months, you know, payment reserve. And, you know, these are all just additional questions that all this stuff is designed to populate on your term sheet, which I'll show you right now. So here's your term sheet, auto-generated from the system. A lot of companies use this. You've probably seen this floating around out there. So you'll be your logo. You can set whatever originator you want to put on there. Typically it's whoever's the system owner, but you can swap it out with whoever the actual lender is if you prefer. And it's nice and clean, very detailed. right? And you can put your own additional terms and requirements and disclosures, and then the borrower can sign this, right? So let's go ahead and send this out to the borrower. So I have a bunch of templates in here. This one is called the pre-approval template. It's going to go to the borrower, and it's pre-written, right? Beautifully designed and written. Link to full app, and let's go ahead and add the term sheet. You select the term sheet at the credit auth and send that out, right? Click send. And what it looks like on the borrower end is this right here. Borrower gets a nice welcome email, link to the full app, you know, click here to sign the term sheet. Let's go ahead and show you what that looks like. And this loads very mobile friendly. So on their phone, they can sign this, or desktop, obviously. They can review it, click to sign, draw or type their signature, and that's it. And then the second important call to action is the full app. Because the quick app, we just got the basic information that we needed to determine eligibility. But if they're ready to move forward, let's get this deal into processing, underwriting, and build out their loan file. So the full app is meant to capture all that detailed information, their address, mailing address if it's different, you know, social, date of birth, you know, if there's a co-borrower, we need their information. You know, on the entity level, we want the EIN number. We want maybe the business address, all the members of that entity, you know, who, you know, obviously if, you know, this guy owns 50%, this guy owns 25, this guy has 25. We even support, a member being an entity and then that entity having its own layer of partners and members there. So it's a very thought out system. You know, we're even asking about, are they authorized to even sign to make this loan, right? That's important. Borrower background, now we're getting into more like bankruptcy disclosures, lien information, foreclosure history, right? I want to highlight something. There's a lot of questions here you're seeing in the full app. You can obviously turn on and off all these fields and sections accordingly. You can make it conditional to the product type that we're dealing with, okay? So here we're asking about list three examples of past deals. You know, this is just nice to know. You know, how many projects do you have in progress? How many investment properties do you have? Do you have any professional licenses? Your primary investment strategy? You're building a profile. And remember, we save all this for the borrower, and every time they come back, it all preloads for them. So they don't need to do this every time they do a deal. And, you know, what's the assets? You know, obviously that'll change over time, but it'll remember what they entered in last time, and then they can update it accordingly. So you can get like a nice little net worth summary on your borrower if you want it. Here you have schedule of real estate. Some people like to have it all input into the system and it spits out a nice clean PDF report of it. Otherwise, some clients prefer to have an upload. And here you can see on mouse over, you know, please enter in your track record of sold properties and your schedule of owned real estate. You can also upload this data in the next step for required docs. So they don't have to do this all manually. They can actually upload it as well. Here's your terms, subject property details. Here you can have more than one property, so it can be cross-collateralized. Additional questions, title, attorneys, escrow, insurance. These are all contacts associated to the loan. And I can actually draw my signature. Isn't that handy? A nice digital signature pad right embedded on the form. You know, this would be your terms and conditions for pulling credit and any other important disclosures that you want to include there. And then I can submit. And watch this. Step two of the full app is going to have some additional documents that are needed. We're a little bit further down the funnel. So maybe now we're going to ask for proof of insurance. Right, or if there's GC license insurance bond, if that's a requirement for this type of loan, construction loan, we might ask for that. You know, exit strategy letter, You know, so these are things that we didn't ask on the quick app, but now we're further down the stage. So let's go ahead and ask for it. If they have it, great. If they don't, well, the processor is going to be nudging them to get that stuff. Okay. Again, so I can drag and drop and upload from my mobile phone and or desktop as well. Everything that you just saw on that web form converts to an application that's PDF for the borrower and for you. So look at this PDF. Everything that they just filled out magically converts to a PDF. So you'll always have a digital PDF loan app of all the different loan products you offer. And as you make changes throughout time in the system and adding fields, it'll always show up here on your loan app. So there's no custom work needed with developers and PDFs. That's always a big pain in the butt and takes a lot of time, right? And at the bottom, you have the signature and the IP address of when it was signed, right? So this serves as your digital loan app and it converted to PDF. So what happens from here? You know, we did the quick app, full app, you know, let's go ahead and put our processing hat on and look at some of these docs, right? So for example, let's go to some of the docs in here. You know, in this sample file, you can see like I've already dispositioned quite a few. So some of them say resend not legible, resend wrong doc, needs legal review. You know, a lot of negative stuff in here. But I just wanted, showing you that like you have different statuses for documents, right? And you can make comments in here. So if I were to say, you know, let's say the entity docs needs managed review. So actually, hey, you sent me, please, resend the operating agreement signed by all partners, right? That's a common thing that might come up. And I can notify the borrower, co-borrower, broker, and even the members of the entity so that everybody knows what's missing and needed. That's what we make that a big deal. Always be able to communicate clearly in the system, right? So if I hit save, it'll notify everybody there. But more importantly, this is where the best feature comes in. How do we get all these documents on autopilot to be collected by, the borrower? Ready? Here's the magic trick. Let's type in the template, loan status required docs. We're going to send this to the borrower, CC maybe the co-borrower or the broker, right? And any other members of our team that we want to get this email. And look at the body. All the items that are missing, needed, status, notes, everything that was put in the borrower notes or the underwriting conditions are visible by the borrower. And there's a link to upload everything right here. And where the autopilot comes in is I click yes to automate it. And we're going to send this out every day, maybe every other day, maybe once a week. We can choose custom dates, right? But let's go for the every day, every weekday, and only send it if we're in processing or underwriting. That is the trick right there. And that makes a lot of good business sense, right? Because if you move the file to clear to close or you kill it, there's no need to send them this email. But if it's actively being processed and underwritten, very likely new things are being added, notes are being made, conditions are being, thrown in the mix, right? So every day the email goes out, it will always be the latest update of what's needed and missing, okay? So once I click send, that goes out, and this is what the borrower gets right here. Nice, friendly email every day giving them information. And that what that does for you is it's awesome customer service. Borrowers, brokers know what's going on. They're not bugging you, your processor, the AE, the loan officer. It's such a daisy chain, extended feedback loop when they have to go through three different people to get an update. That takes, a couple days at best. And then there's usually lost information along the way. And so this really gives everyone instant access to real-time, accurate information that's from the source of truth. And when they click this link, this takes you immediately to the borrower portal where they can see what's going on, what's the target closing date, and upload some documents, right? And they can see all the notes that have been made. They can download templates associated to some of the needs list, if that's relevant, right? And this would be your company name. And this URL would be your URL with our private label package. So that's why, you know, it makes it look like the whole entire system runs off your domain and it's your tech stack. It's your custom system. It makes you guys look extra professional, committed to the industry, and builds a lot of trust. All right, so at this point, we've got the quick app, full app uploaded with documents, you know, processor dispositioned a lot of things. And we saw how easy it was to disposition it. I want to highlight the workflow steps because that's what really keeps everybody humming along in a very logical manner. So these are all action items that your team needs to do, whether it's your loan officer doing the application steps, which makes sense, right? Your processing underwriting team working in tandem to get all these items done, right? And closing team does these items here. Post-closing does these items here. You know, when you're dealing with draws, you can deal with this. So these are all workflows. Workflows have steps. These steps can be dynamic based off the product type, the property state, the borrower type. You know, you control that logic. So the system is really smart. Not only is it based on all those product type features, you know, loan parameters, but the investor and lender that you're dealing with, you can overlay their required workflow steps, their required docs, okay? And let me show you what I mean by that. So if I go back to the docs tab, you see this internal loan program? So, you know, ABC Family Office is going to be my capital source, and they have to do a background check that uses LexisNexis. They won't take this deal unless I do a LexisNexis background check. That's their requirement, and that's called an overlay. Because I know I'm giving it to them, I now know to process it in the way that they're going to want it. Again, making everything very smart and conditional to your investor or lender that you're working with on this loan. So again, required docs, workflow steps, and any of the fields throughout the application, right? You know, I'll go back here to the full app. So some of these questions and fields that we went through, you know, we have almost 2,000 fields throughout the system. You can make any of those fields or create custom fields and make them conditional to the investor you're working with or the product, etc. Okay?